Our time in Paris is coming to a close, which is so sad. I wish I could stay here forever. C'est la vie. We must move on. So this is the halfway point of our European trip, and it marks the start of... It marks the start of our European road trip, and apparently...
We're excited.
We got a Beamer. We're super, super excited. There she is, our new best friend. What do you think, Kim?
It looks awesome.
Apparently driving in Paris is much more difficult than we thought. We were having a hard time even figuring out where to go or what lane to drive in or how to read the traffic signals. And there was a point in which Kim just kept driving straight because there was no barrier. And she just said, I can drive straight, so I'm going to drive straight, despite what the Garmin GPS was telling us.
Got us where we needed to go.
Amazingly. But...
Yes.
Makes all the difference. We'll get lost anywhere right now.
We're just hoping that our stuff doesn't get locked in the hotel because we're about half hour late for our checkout.
Whew, it all fits. Barely.
It's been long. I need to look at the road. No messing around.
I think that's 52 euros for 8 gallons of gas. That's a lot of money. Only at a rest stop in France. We also happen to be in Champagne, so it makes sense. But only at a rest stop in France would you get baguettes and champagne. It's pretty cool. They do things right here. Trying the cappuccino. Kim has refilled on her Haribo. I'm enjoying my cappuccino. And we have our handy dandy life vest that is a prerequisite here in France that you have to have one in the car in case you have to get out of the car and fix your car on the side of the road. So we're ready to go. All rested and restocked. And it builds. And it builds. Taking the A4 to Innsbruck. No. To Tübingen, which is Germany. We've got another 4 hours to go, people. 4 hours. There are a lot of toll roads in France, so hopefully we figure this out correctly. It looks like for different kinds of cars, there's different charges.
4-7, maybe? Which is still expensive.
How much? 21 euro?
That is a lot.
Do you need mine? We made it through. 21 euro and 40 cents. Horror.
Wow.
We'll drown it out with Brittany. I
down.
I think we've been 4 hours, 5 hours on the road. We're getting there. We think we just entered Germany. We have no sign telling us that we did, but that waterway that we just passed over, whatever it was, a dam or something, I think that was the border. According to our GPS, it says France on one side of it. And I jinxed us. We stopped for the first time in 4.5 hours. So here we go again. So here we are, Deutschland. Okay. Ah, there it is! There's a sign! I can add a proverbial stamp to my passport. I am now in Germany.
Baden-Württemberg.
Missed the sign. Ah, here we go. That's why there's a holdup. How picturesque. This is the Rhine River, we think, that we're crossing over. And you didn't see any of it. Ah, this way. Yes. We've left France, and I thought that maybe we could do a little... Oh, there's like a lint on the camera lens. We've left France, and I thought we could do a little recap of thoughts on Paris. What have we thought? Everyone wears blue and white striped shirts like the hipsters in Silver Lake. Everyone. So I brought my blue and white striped shirt and wore it one day. I felt very French. Everyone carries a baguette and eats the baguette on the street. Kim said she doesn't understand having bread open to the weather and to the elements. Huh. Whatever. You want your baguette? It's there, under your arm. Just pick at it, and when you're hungry as you're walking, you eat it. Works. What else about Paris? Smiles are hard to come by, but once they warm up to you, very friendly, very charming people. Men are very attractive and very charming. This was a surprise to us. We'll stop there. What else? Paris. We saw a guy walking with a poetry book. He was walking across the Seine on the bridge reading poetry. I thought that was just in movies. It apparently happens in Paris. Yeah. I think that's it for now. Things are very expensive, as we've shared with you. What else? Anything else about Paris? Apparently not. So there you have it. That was Paris. We will be back in France in a few days. But now we're in Germany, so say hello to us in Germany. In German.
Guten Tag.
Guten Tag, or hello, as Kim says, is also a common way of saying hello in Germany. So, Guten Tag.
They're definitely going fast, because I'm like 150 kilometers over.
We're on the Autobahn, and the people in the fast lane are booking it. And we're going 150 kilometers. We're going at least 80, 90 miles per hour. So they're going fast. Eesh. 7 hours and 125 euros later, we're almost at our destination to begin Germany. Just so you know, if you plan on doing a road trip from France to Germany, it takes a long time. You hit a lot of toll roads. Gas is incredibly expensive, but it was fun, and it was nice to have the flexibility of your own car as opposed to taking the train, but obviously the train is a great option as well. And because my sister is a rock star traveler, we were also ready for all of the different driving rules and signs that we're not familiar with along the way. So she had gotten this book and made copies, Backroads France, which helped us with navigating the differences, as well as printing out this map with directions, because the GPS was very fickle. And if you rent a car in Europe, bring your own GPS. There are many things that we wish we wouldn't have packed in our suitcases. GPS was not one of them. We wish we would have brought our Garmin because we have the same exact GPS that they gave us for 10 euros a day. So that was a ripoff, but lesson learned. So there you have it. We're almost at our destination. Kim just informed me that our dad recommended we bring our GPS and that she declined because on the website for the car rental place, it says that these cars are equipped with GPS. We had no idea it meant they'll give you the Garmin to take with you, which we found out are not always updated with the most current maps. So, Dad, you were right. We should have brought your Garmin.